Hi friends, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we have to discuss about example problem on operations on sets in discrete mathematics and graph theory course. The given problem is let mu, mu is universal set, it contains the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And set A contains the elements 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. And set B contains the elements 2, 4, 5 and 9. Then compute the following. First one is A union B. Second one is A intersection B. Third one is A bar. Fourth one is B bar. Fifth one is A bar union B bar. Sixth one is A bar intersection B bar. Seventh one is A union B whole bar. Eighth one is A intersection B whole bar. Ninth one is A minus B. Tenth one is B minus A. 11th one is A delta B. And 12th one is A Cartesian product B. So this is the most important problem on set theory. Now we have to solve one by one. First one is A union B. So A union B is nothing but we have to combine the elements of set A and set B. Then it becomes the A union B. So set A is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 union, set B is 2, 4, 5, 9. After combining the elements, any duplicate elements are there, it can be write only once. So 1, 2 can be there 2 times. At that time, you have to write only one time. 4 is occurred 2 times. Then you have to write only one time. Next one is 5. Next one is 6. Next one is 8. Next one is 9. So, A union B contains the elements 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. Next, the second bit, A intersection B. A intersection B is nothing but common elements between set A and set B. So that means whatever the common elements between set A and set B can be considered as A intersection B. So set A is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. Intersection set B is 2, 4, 5, 9. So what are the common elements between them? 2, 4. 2, 4. So 2, 4 elements are available in both set A and set B. Then it can be considered as A intersection B that contains only 2 elements, 2 and 4. Next, third bit, A bar. So A bar is nothing but mu minus A, where mu is nothing but universal set. So whatever the elements that are there in set A, that elements can be removed from the universal set. After removing that elements from the universal set, whatever the remaining elements are there in the universal set, that elements comes under A bar. So now, what? Universal set contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, minus is nothing but set difference symbol. సెట్ ఏ కంటైన్స్ 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమూవ్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఇన్ సెట్ ఏ ఇన్ యూనివర్సల్ సెట్. సో 1 ఈస్ దేర్, సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమూవ్ 1. 2 ఈస్ దేర్, యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమూవ్ 2. నెక్స్ట్ 3 ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్, సో 3 కమ్స్ అండర్ ఏ బార్. నెక్స్ట్ 4 ఈస్ అవైలబుల్. నెక్స్ట్ 5 ఈస్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ ద సెట్ ఏ, సో దాట్ ఎలిమెంట్ కమ్స్ అండర్ ఏ బార్. నెక్స్ట్ 6 ఈస్ అవైలబుల్. నెక్స్ట్ 7 ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్ ఇన్ సెట్ ఏ, దాట్ ఎలిమెంట్ కమ్స్ అండర్ ఏ బార్. 8 ఈస్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ సెట్ ఏ, అండ్ 9 ఈస్ నాట్ అవైలబుల్ ఇన్ సెట్ ఏ, సో దిస్ ఎలిమెంట్ కమ్స్ అండర్ ఏ బార్. సో ఇన్ ద ఏ బార్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ 3, 5, 7, 9. నెక్స్ట్ వన్, ఫోర్త్ వన్ ఈస్ బి బార్. సో బి బార్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ మ్యూ మైనస్ బి. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ దట్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ సెట్ బి, దట్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ కెన్ బి రిమూవ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ యూనివర్సల్ సెట్. వాట్ ఎవర్ ద రిమైనింగ్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద యూనివర్సల్ సెట్, దట్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ కమ్స్ అండర్ బి బార్. సో 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minus, what are the elements in set B? 2, 4, 5, 9. So element 1 is not there in set B, that element comes under B bar. Element 2 is there, you have to remove in the universal set. Element 3 is not available in the set B, that element comes under B bar. Element 4 is available in set B, that can be removed from the universal set. Element 5 is available in the set B, that can be removed from the universal set. Element 6 is not available in set B, that can be comes under B bar. Element 7 is not available in set B, that element comes under B bar. Next one, element 8 is not available in set B, that element comes under B bar. Element 9 is available in B, that element can be removed from the universal set. So what are the elements in B bar? 1, 3, 6, 7, 8. Next, fifth bit is A bar union B bar. So already we are finding the A bar, already we are finding the B bar, then you have to perform the union operation between A bar and B bar. So 3 A bar is 3, 5, 7, 9. B bar is 1, 3, 6, 7, 8. Here union operation between A bar and B bar contains the elements 1. Element 3 is occurred 2 times. You have to write only 1 time. Next one is 5. Next one is 6. Next 7 can be occurred 2 times. You have to write 1 time. Next one is 8. Next one is 9. So we have to combine the elements of A bar and B bar. So then you have to write 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, 2 elements are repeated, 3 and 7. So that can be write only once. This is A bar union B bar. Next one is A bar intersection B bar. That means what are the common elements between A bar and B bar? That elements comes under A bar intersection B bar. So 3, 5, 7, 9 intersection. So 1, 3, 6, 7, 8. So what are the common elements between them? 3 and 7. So 3 and 7. These elements comes under A bar and B bar. Next one is A union B whole bar. Next one is A union B whole bar. The formula for A union B whole bar is mu minus A union B. Already mu is there. Already A union B is there. Already we are finding the A union B as first bit. Okay, that result is here. Mu is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minus A union B. A union B is 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. We have to remove the elements from universal set. Whatever the remaining elements are there, that elements comes under A union B whole bar. So 1 is there, we have to remove 1. 2 is there, we have to remove here. Next one, 3. 3 is not there, so that you have to write. Next, 4 is there, you have to remove 4. 5 is there, you have to remove here. 6 is there, you have to remove here. But 7 is not there, you have to write 7. Next one, 8 is there, you have to remove here. 9 is there, you have to remove here. After removing these elements in universal set, what are the remaining elements? Only 3 and 7. These two elements comes under A union B whole bar. Next one is 8th bit. 8th bit is A intersection B whole bar. That means mu minus A intersection B. So what is universal set? So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minus A intersection B value is set of 2 comma 4. So that means we have to remove these two elements from the universal set. After removing that two elements, what are the remaining elements are there? That elements comes under A intersection B whole bar. We have to remove 2 and 4. After removing 2 and 4, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these elements comes under A intersection B whole bar. Next one is 9th one, A minus B. A minus B. That means whatever the elements in B, that elements can be removed from set A. Whatever the remaining elements in set A, that elements comes under A minus B. So set A contains 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 minus set B contains 2, 4, 5, 9. So here 2 is there, you have to remove 2. Here 4 is there, you have to remove 4. 5 is not there, there is no remove. 9 is not there, there is no remove. So whatever the remaining elements are there in set A, that elements comes under A minus B. After removing 2 comma 4, what is the remaining elements? That are 1, 6, 8. 1, 6, 8. These elements comes under A minus B. Next one is B minus A. So B minus A is nothing but whatever the elements in set A, that elements are removed from set B. Whatever the remaining elements in set B, that elements comes under B minus A. What is set B? So 2, 4, 5, 9. Minus, what is A? A is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now, element 1, it is not there. Element 2 is there, you have to remove from set B. Element 4 is there, you have to remove from set B. Element 6 is not there, element 8 is not there. So after removing 2 and 4 in set B, what is the remaining elements? 5 and 9. So 5 and 9 are the elements comes under B minus A. Next, 11th one is A delta B. A delta B. So what is the formula for A delta B? That is A minus B union B minus A. A minus B union B minus A. Already A minus B is there. Already B minus is there. You have to combine the elements of A minus B and B minus A. That elements comes under A delta B. What is A minus B value? 1, 6, 8. Union. What is B minus A value? That is 5 and 9. So after combining the elements of A minus B and B minus A, we are getting 1 comma, 5 comma, 6 comma, 8 comma, 9. So 1, 5, 6, 8, 9. Next, last bit. A Cartesian product B. So A is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. Cartesian product B is 2, 4, 5, 9. So Cartesian product means you have to write the order pairs by using every element of set A that are related with elements of set B. Okay. For example, 1 is related with 2. Then what is the order pair you are getting? 1 comma 2. Next one, 1 is related with 4. What is the order pair we are getting? 1 comma 4. Next, 1 is related with 5. Then what is the order pair you are getting? 1 comma 5. 1 is related with 9. What is the order pair you are getting? 1 comma 9. So 1 is related with all the elements of set B. Next, you are taking element 2. 2 is related with 2. So we are getting the order pair 2 comma 2. 2 is related with 4. You are getting the element 2 comma 4 as order pair. Next one, 2 is related with 5. You are getting the order pair 2 comma 5. 2 is related with 9. You are getting the order pair 2 comma 9. So 2 is related with all the elements of set B. Next, you are taking the next element in set A, that is 4. So 4 is related with the 2. You are getting the order pair 4 comma 2. 4 is related with 4. You are getting the order pair 4 comma 4. 4 is related with 5. You are getting the order pair 4 comma 5. 4 is related with 9. You are getting the order pair 4 comma 9. So 4 is related with all the elements of set B. Next, I am taking 6. 6 is related with 2. We are getting the order pair 6 comma 2. 6 is related with 4. You are getting the order pair 6 comma 4. 6 is related with 5. You are getting the order pair 6 comma 5. 6 is related with 9. You are getting the order pair 6 comma 9. Next, 6 is related with all the elements of set B. Next, you are taking the next element in set A, 8. 8 is related with 2. You are getting the order pair 8 comma 2. 8 is related with 4. You are getting the order pair 8 comma 4. 8 is related with 5. You are getting the order pair 8 comma 5. Next, 8 is related with 9. You are getting the order pair 8 comma 9. So, each and every element of set A is related with every element of set B. Whatever the order pairs we are getting, that order pairs comes under A cross B. Sir, here set A contains how many number of elements? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Set B contains how many number of elements? 2, 4, 5, 9. That means 4 elements. Here 5 elements, here 4 elements. So 5 into 4, there are 20 order pairs we are getting in A Cartesian product B. This is the Cartesian product symbol. Okay, so we have to count whether 20 order pairs you are getting or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 order pairs you are getting. Each and every order pair contains two components. So I am taking 1 comma 2. 1 is one component, 2 is another component. Element 1 belongs to set A, element 2 belongs to set B. In every order pair, there are two components are there. First component always belongs to set A, second component always belongs to set B. Okay. In this way, we have to solve the operations on sets. Suppose you have to find out B Cartesian product A, then you have to write B first, A next. Every element of B is related with every element of set A. In this way also, you are getting 20 order pairs, but A Cartesian product B not equal to B Cartesian product A. Because, so these order pairs are reverse we are getting. So that A Cartesian product B not equal to B Cartesian product A. Next, another relation is A minus B not equal to B minus A. So see this one, A minus B result is 168, B minus A result is 59. So that A minus B not equal to B minus A. This is one important relation. Okay, so I hope all of you understanding this video. If you have any doubts, please put your doubts in the comment section. I will try to clarify your doubts. If you really understanding this video, please subscribe my YouTube channel. So, Devvela Srinivasrao. After subscribing my YouTube channel, click on the bell icon to get the future updates in my YouTube channel. In the comment box, I am giving the total playlist link. Please use this link to get all the videos of discrete mathematics and graph theory course. Thank you one and all for watching this video.